good, YouTube? It's your girl, Tiara Contessa, and I am back with another video. You already know your girl, Tiara Contessa. I'm back with another video. Coming back, doing it. Back better than ever. So today, I'm going to be doing a review on the crown case. As you can see by the title of this video, thumbnail. If you guys want to see how I created this look, definitely keep watching. That was kind of corny, but you know. Check out the description box where the link to the Crayon Cases website will be. Do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Comment below what company you would like to see me review next. Makeup details will be at the end of this video. So yes, I will see you guys in a little bit. Today I'm going to be doing a review slash unboxing video and a tutorial, of course, using the Crayon Case. For those who do not know who the Crayon Case is, it is a black owned business that is located in New Orleans. The founder of the Crayon Case, her name is Raynell, also known as Supa, who is amazing. Her personality is there. Supa's pushing a million followers on Instagram. I just think that she's an amazing woman. Like, I love her personality. I love that she does not care about what anyone has to say. And I just wanna say thank you so much to the Crayon Case team for sending me all this stuff. Like, I'm shocked. I did get sent a lot of stuff. All right, so let's just jump right into it. So the first thing that I'm going to show you guys is the Conceal Me palettes. These are concealer palettes that hold 6 concealers in them. As you can see, this is more of like a darker toned concealer, which I would say is definitely good for contouring. If you have a deeper skin tone, I definitely will say that this is good for you. You can even highlight with this. And then they have another one. Again, this is the 6 color concealer palette. This is lighter tones in here. So if you are of the lighter complexion and you would like to purchase one of these, depending on what you want to use it for, like I think you got some color correcting stuff in here. Some of them have a pink undertone, some of them have a red undertone, and some of them have the yellow undertone. So again, these cater to everyone, like literally. If you're of the lighter complexion, you can get both of them. And if you have a deeper complexion, you can get both of them as well. So feel free to pick up either which one or both of them. The Conceal Me palettes range for $10. For $10, you get 6 concealers in one palette. That's great. So we're definitely gonna test out the pigmentation of the concealer palettes. The next thing that I'm gonna show you guys is the contouration notebook. On the back, it literally looks like a notebook. So cute. All right, let's get this out. You slide it out and then it literally looks like a book. And this is what we have. You get 6 different colors as far as your contouring powder goes. I can see myself using a couple of colors in here. Actually, all of the colors in here, because I'm just extra. Again, if you're of the deeper complexion or the lighter complexion, this will definitely work for you as well. This goes for $14. So for $14, you get 6 pens. You can use these for anything. Like, I would honestly use Bobby for a transition shade. I would use any of these for a transition shade. Like, look at that. You can either set your highlight with that, or you can even put that on your brow bone. Again, these 2 colors up here. Listen, I'm gonna show you guys what you could do with this. We also got a brush cleaner, which is $5. It's a sponge where you will basically rub your dirty brush. Now the brush that I'm about to use is not dirty, to get the product off of it, and it's clean. I was blessed enough and I was actually sent 6 of their eyebrow pomades. So since I have six, that means that I have six different wigs, and I have a eyebrow pomade to go with my wig depending on how I feel. The eyebrow gel goes for $15. For those who do not know what eyebrow pomade is, I will show you what you can do with the Crayon Cases eyebrow pomade. This color ebony I'm gonna be using, it probably looks a little bit darker on camera, but this color is spot on amazing. She hit it on the nail. One of the most talked about products from the Crayon Case is their beauty blender. Look at that. Like, you've never seen a beauty blender that looks like this before. I love pink. I've heard things about this beauty blender. I've watched tutorials on this beauty blender. Everyone has their own preference, whether if you like to use a brush to blend out your foundation or if you like to use a beauty blender. Me personally, I like to use a beauty blender. We're definitely gonna get into this beauty blender a little bit because some people had some stuff to say about this beauty blender, so we will see. Like, girl, what are you talking about? What are you talking about? We are going to see and lay those things to rest, okay? The Crayon Case sent me a ton of brushes. Like, I got so many brushes. This isn't even the half of what I received. Like, this with the green, oh my goodness, girl. I knew what I was doing when I was in the fabric store. Can I get into this after I show you the other brushes? Because I am so excited to use this, okay? Like, literally, girl. When you can color outside of the lines and get an A+, like, come on now. Who would not be excited? I'm going to start off with the eyeshadow brush set. And if I'm not mistaken, there are seven brushes that come in this. One thing I like about the Crayon Case, I'm gonna tell you right now, is that everything comes protected, like, bro. Now, you would think that these are just all in here. No. They're protected. New Orleans all the way to the other side. To me, my brushes were protected. So that definitely makes me really happy. Like, the box says you get seven brushes. I have so many brushes, I don't even know what I'm gonna do. So the 7-piece eyeshadow brushes are actually sold out. But these do range for $14. For future references, when they restock, we're gonna see what these brushes can do, and you might wanna go get you some. I was also sent an angled brush. It's pink, so I'm definitely loving that. This is what that looks like. They also sent me another brush. This is a little cute on-the-go brush. You have your spoolie on one side, and you have your angled brush on another. I have so many brushes that was sent to me, I don't even know what they use them for. This brush that was sent to me, I'm gonna use this brush. Oh my God, I don't even know if I wanna use this brush. It's just so cute. This brush is so cute. Okay, are you guys ready? The Crayon Case sent me their Judy fan brush. This is what it looks like. Do you guys see this? What? Oh! This brush is $8, but gosh. Like, oh my gosh. The colors. Like, why do you think I got this backdrop? Girl. And then, can we talk about how I also got another brush, which came in a package like this. So I was like, okay, what the hell is that? What the hell? Girl, I got me another Judy brush. And this one right here, I don't think I'm ever gonna use, not even today. So again, like I said, everything is protected. Everything is protected when it comes to the Crayon Case. There's nothing that you need to worry about. Oh my gosh. This brush, like, girl. Oh, wow. Wait, that was an accident. Oh my God. I'm about to cry. Stop. Wow, okay. I just need a moment. This is so soft. Excuse me. This is what the Judy brush looks like. I'm trying to see if you guys can see the detailing on it. Right here, it actually says the Crayon Case. Like, look at the handle. Like, girl. Oh, this shit is so soft. And there you go. It's not going anywhere. So you do not have to worry about packaging. But can we just get into this? Like, Please excuse me for the loudness, for being dramatic to whoever might feel some type of way about it, but the colors, this is amazing. So currently this is on sale. This box normally goes for $55. It is on sale for $40. You guys are definitely gonna see how I feel about these five brushes. It's pink lettering and it literally has the crayon case written on it. Love the detailing of these brushes. All of them have the crayon case written somewhere on them, all the way down to the smallest brush that was sent to me. That's really dope. Pay attention to details. This is by far one of the best things that I've ever received. Hold up now. I'm gonna keep this packaging. I don't know where I'm gonna put this, but I'm gonna put this somewhere where I can just see it. Now that we have looked at all of the brushes, I'm just gonna set them aside to go on to the jewels of the review. The jewels, oh, the jewels. Look at this. Like, girl, I'm not even gonna tell you guys that I wanted to use this as a clutch one day. Oh. Hold on. That was my first time opening that, I'm not gonna lie. So that was my, like, wow. I can use this as a clutch, hold on. Before I even open this bag, let me tell you guys that this bag is actually made with a really nice material. Like, you know how you get like your regular makeup bags sometimes and they're like made out of some type of like fabric or something? This is not made out of fabric, bitch, okay. This is the front of the bag and this is the back. And on the back, again, it says the crayon case. This might be my Saturday night clutch. And there is enough room for you to either put anything you wanna put in it as far as whatever you need when you're going out. Pepper spray, first and foremost, and whatever else you need. I like all of this stuff, I really do. Like, the packaging has got me for real, like when you see it on the website and on Instagram, when you see this on social media, it's one thing. But when you get it in person, you're wowed. We're gonna move on to the crayon cases colored pencils. Now, these are their lip liners. The names of these are Black Ranked, Bare, Plump, Magenta, Nudist, and Coffee. So you get six lip liners, or I wanna say maybe five lip liners and one eyeliner, because this is black, so I would say use this as an eyeliner, but again, if you're doing like any kind of lip you wanna do, you can definitely use this as well. The first thing I want to talk about is how, again, the detailing. Everything literally states that it's from the crayon case. I think the detailing is amazing. Can we just talk about how these are like so long? You get so much product. Like, these are better than MAC, okay? Shout out to MAC Cosmetics, but MAC product is not as long as this, okay? For six lip liners, you are paying $10 for a, I'm not even gonna talk about it, because if you know about MAC, then you know how much their lip liners are. I love MAC dearly, but Supa really did this, because I'ma just swatch it for you, and then you could just look at it yourself. Do you see how nude that is? Hold up. Because for those who might say that it's not that good, for those who really don't know makeup, like, you guys are gonna see that and you guys are not gonna think much of it because you don't know too much about makeup, but I'm gonna show you a more pigmented color and then you could tell me. That is one stroke. Can we talk about the pigmentation? When I tell you that they're smooth and creamy, like if you have dry and chapped lips, this is gonna be just so comfortable. It's just, I don't know, the formula or something about it is just smooth and creamy and it just feels good on my hands. So Can't wait to put it on my lip. These go for $10. We are going to jump into their lipsticks. I received all of the Crayon Cases liquid lipsticks. I'm just gonna go ahead and swatch them off for you. These are what the liquid lipsticks look like after they dry down. The first one is Marie. The second one is Hell City. The third one is Holly Grove. The fourth one is Weed Hat. The fifth one is Bear. The sixth one is Murder Matte. The seventh one is Raven. And the last one is Graveyard. So there are definitely some really good colors in here. My favorite, of course, is gonna be more towards Marie and Hell City because I am a nude girl. I love nudes. The last three are very different, although they might look similar in pictures. They're very different. Murder Matte is more of a red. And then here you have Raven, which is definitely that plum color. And then here you have Graveyard, which is definitely a purple undertone. Like, this is a matte purple versus this one, Raven, which is definitely a deep plum, which is a deeper purple. Any of the lip liners go with any of these shades, which is really cool. Watch my smoke palette. All of the names of the eyeshadows are on the back of the packaging, and then these are what the shadows look like. So this I am very excited for. The one that we're gonna use today, I'm going to swatch, which is gonna be Shirley Temple. So I'm just gonna take my finger and just... So that's the green. Tokyo Tea and Shirley Temple. As you can see, they are definitely very pigmented. I'm so excited to be using this today. They are very well known for their highlighters. This one is Anglola, which is a gold. This is Glowcane, which this is Rosy Glores, which is a pink. The highlighters go for $15, just in case you are wondering. I'm going to take the Brow Pomade in the color Ebony, and I'm about to just fill in my brow. It's definitely very creamy, and it just glides right on your brush. So you definitely want to be careful as far as how much product you take and apply. Yeah, that's definitely very pigmented. So I'm just gonna take light strokes. I am using my hand so light because the product is so pigmented. So that's what we got so far. I'm definitely feeling it. I think Ebony is perfect. So I'm just gonna take light strokes and just filling in my brow. So as you can see, that it's really dark. Going to take this concealer brush that was inside of the eyeshadow brush set. I'm going to take this concealer here and conceal under my brows. All right, it's honestly creamy. It has a smell to it. I don't know what, but it definitely has a smell to it. And I'm just gonna go ahead and conceal my brows. Can you guys see that? All right, I'm gonna use a lighter color because although it looks really light in this pen, it's really not. not that late. It's not as late as I expected it to be. Yeah, that one's a lot better. And it's more of a pink undertone. So my brows are concealed and they look really good. I'm actually really surprised on how good this eyebrow pomade is. Telling you, black owned business, baby. Let's get it. I can't use these only because the undertone is really throwing it off. And I don't want to throw off my eyeshadow. So you can see the difference between the concealers of how this is a yellow undertone and this is just, I don't know. I am a yellow undertone for sure. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just gonna take my finger and just blend that out. Now that my eyelids are set, I'm gonna go ahead and jump right into this tutorial. Some of the eyeshadows that I'm gonna be using is not gonna be from the Watch My Smoke palette, only because I need transition colors. But when you look into this palette, there is not a transition shade, which is not a problem, but I need my makeup to be very much blended, so I'm gonna have to throw in one or two different colors in order to do that. So yes, but this is a very, very nice palette. Do not get it twisted. So the first color that I'm gonna take is Saddle by MAC. I'm just taking a big fluffy brush and applying Saddle by MAC all over my lid, color on the outer corner of my eye. And then of course, I'm gonna take it in and blend it towards the inner corner of my eye. Now that we have MAC Saddle applied all over the lid, I'm gonna go ahead and take MAC Mystic Velvet, which is a red. Literally, it's a red. I'm gonna take this with a blending brush from the crayon case. This is just a blending brush that was inside of the eyeshadow brush set. I'm just gonna take that and take the red and just apply that right below Saddle. And it's not too dark to where it's gonna take the focus away from our lid color. I'm going to go back in because I don't wanna lose that Saddle color by MAC. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take that brush that I used with Saddle, and I'm not gonna apply any more product, but I'm just gonna just take it and just make sure that those two colors are blended. If I didn't have any transition shades, to me, it just wouldn't look right. Yeah. I'm going to take another color by MAC. I've had this for so long that the name of it is like scratched. But yes, and as you can see, I hit pan on this a long time ago using that same brush that we just used. We're not gonna take too much because I'm gonna darken it up. And I'm just gonna go ahead and build that color up. You can see that it's already darkening up just a little bit, not too much. You definitely wanna take your time blending because you want everything to be seamless. Go back in and you see how it looks a little harsh right here? I'm just gonna go ahead and just blend that out. And I'm just gonna take the first blending brush that we used the first time, which is just a really big fluffy blending brush. And just just make sure that everything is accordingly. Okay, so now that we have all of our different shades nice and blended, I'm gonna go ahead and take that brush that I use to conceal my brows with. I'm just gonna go ahead and apply a white base just so that it really pops. And I am actually not cutting my crease. I'm just gonna apply this on my lid. This does not need to be perfect, but I'm just gonna apply that wherever I want my next color to be. So now we're gonna hop right into the crayon cases, Watch My Smoke palette, and we are going to be using the color Shirley Temple, which is this red right here. Taking this brush from the eyeshadow brush set, it's a nice brush to be able to pack the color on the lid. Wow, okay, this is very much pigmented, okay? Like, did you guys see that? And I'm just gonna take this above my crease. Wow. And I'm packing that color on my lid because I really need that pigmentation. And then I'm gonna go ahead and take another blending brush that is from the crayon case and go ahead and blend that out. Still see saddle. I'm not gonna add any more product, but I'm just gonna make sure that saddle is nice and blended. That looks amazing. Like that. Oh, I'm feeling myself. That's why it's important to have transition shades. I just think this is a nice, cute matte look, okay? So now that I've finished my eyes, I'm just gonna go ahead off camera and add my eyeliner and lashes, and I'll be right back. I'm just gonna fast forward this part. For those who are probably gonna be a little bit irritated that I'm not going full on detailed with the next part, please be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and be on the lookout for my very detailed makeup tutorials that I will be having very soon. Be on the lookout. Wow. I literally do not like applying my foundation with a brush, but this is something different. My face has no streaks. My skin has no streaks. Okay, crayon case. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna use a beauty blender only because this brush is gonna be way too big. This beauty blender, I don't know. The beauty blender is good, but I don't know. I'm gonna try the brush again. Okay then. Wow, I'm not gonna lie, I'm really shocked. I'm gonna need some more of these crayon case. I'm gonna need some more of these. I don't know if it's possible. What the hell? Crayon case, why you do it, sister lady? Can we just talk about this? Wow, this brush to apply foundation is crayon case. Can we talk about this? We gotta talk about this. The Kylie Cosmetics foundation brush that looks exactly like this, except it is a different color. But from what I saw in reviews, the Kylie Cosmetic brush was causing streaks and it was shedding, and that shit was $350, $60, I don't know, but whoa. finished and my highlight is set. I'm gonna go ahead and start contouring. Now, of course, I'm gonna be using the Contourization Notebook. Let's try Bricky, and then if it's not dark enough, then I definitely will use Bobbi. I'm going to be using the contour brush that comes in the 5-piece set. I think for the lips, I'm going to do Marie. Marie is this nude, if you remember the swatch that I showed you guys earlier, it is the lightest color. There is a lip liner that matches Marie, but I'm gonna use more of a brownish color. I'm just gonna go ahead and line my lips and I'll be right back. Then I'm gonna go ahead and take Marie by the crayon case. Just add that color to the center of my lip. So now that I'm officially done using these amazing products that were sent to me, I am going to let you guys know my final thoughts. I'm shocked. So the first thing I want to talk about is the first thing that I used was actually the eyebrow pomade, which if you guys look at my eyebrows, you see that? Like, amazing. I can honestly say that this is a must. The one thing that I do want to talk about, something that didn't really work for me, is this beauty blender. Now, as much as I really rooted for this beauty blender, it just didn't work for me. I just feel like it was a lot harder to blend because of the texture. And I feel like because of the texture, it was taking the product versus blending the product. I'm sure if I had their other beauty blender, I'm sure it would have did just fine. Let's talk about the brushes. There's not much to talk about because at the end of the day, every last one of the brushes that I used pertaining the crayon case was the best brushes that I've used in 2018, period, point blank. So far, these are the best brushes. I don't care what anyone says. I like these. The one brush that I definitely recommend you guys getting, I don't know if you guys can purchase this as a single brush or if you have to buy the set. If you have to buy the 5-brush set, I definitely recommend you getting it. I know it's a little bit pricier, but right now it is actually on sale. Girl, this foundation brush was the best foundation brush I've ever used. Now, let me tell you, this is not, listen, like I was trying to compare this brush to the Kylie Jenner brush. Based off of the reviews that I've watched about the Kylie Jenner brushes, everyone has stated with her foundation brush that it sheds and it leaves streaks. It is a little costly, but you get 5 brushes and just know that the foundation brush is an amazing brush. I cannot stress how amazing this brush set is. Listen, bitch. Go order the brushes. The link is in my description box, so be sure to click on that. I definitely recommend you getting the eyeshadow set. The face brushes are a must, period. Like, let me tell you, this is the Watch My Smoke palette. This is amazing. I only used 1 color in this palette, which is the red. As you guys seen in the tutorial that I gave you, this is pigmented as. Listen, the Watch My Smoke palette is definitely a must. Very pigmented, very easy to blend. The shadows are so pigmented to the point where you do not need to use a lot of this. You can just literally build the color up to your liking. This will definitely last you a long time. Let's talk about these lip liners that I actually said are better than MAC. to me, they're better than MAC for multiple reasons, but bitch, if you're gonna spend nearly $20 on one lip liner, first of all, the amount of product that you actually get with the Crayon Cases lip liners is amazing. Like, these shits are so creamy and ugh, but these glided like right on. The liquid lipstick that I'm wearing is Marie. Girl, I am honestly in love with this one. I do not like matte lipsticks. It's just so uncomfortable, but this is actually pretty comfortable. The highlighter that I use today is the Anglola. Now, let me just start right here. This right here is an amazing highlighter. The Consturation Notebook is amazing. Hands down, I love it. One thing I'm gonna say about the Crayon Case is that all of their products are very pigmented. You do not need a lot of product when it comes to the Crayon Case. I actually bronzed all over my face with this. It was perfect. When I used their brush to blend my contour, I did not find it hard to blend at all. It definitely was very easy to blend and bronze, and it was so soft going across my skin. Like, get with the program. The last thing that I want to talk about is the concealers. I'm gonna be very honest, this did not work for me because of the undertones in the concealer. If there was another concealer that really worked with my undertone, then it would have been perfect. But other than the undertone being an issue, is the only reason why it did not work for me. Other than that, these are very thick. And I did not highlight with this palette because, again, the undertone. I have a yellow undertone. So with that being said, if I use either of these concealers either under my eye or like you guys saw on the brow, it picked up like a pinkish. That did not work for me. It's easy to blend and it does definitely have some good coverage. NARS, I had the same issue. It's nothing with the company itself. It's not the company. It's just the specific color that they offer just does not work for my skin complexion. I use this color to contour only because it was the darkest shade that was there. And that would be the only concealer in here that's gonna work for my contour. Again, these are more red and orange undertones. I definitely think that it is amazing. Like, this was one swipe and look how rich and creamy that is. So again, it's definitely not the product itself. It's just the color variation. This doesn't work for me. This is so pigmented to the point where it's like you do not need a lot of it. That wraps up my Crayon Case review. I just want to say again, thank you so much to Supa. I appreciate you sending me this amazing package. This is what I was able to do with your products. Not only is this a black owned business, but this is a hardworking woman. I'm all for a hardworking woman who is respected. Listen, overall, it is a great, great company. I definitely recommend any of you who are watching this video, go and order from them. They are definitely a company that I say you should invest your money into, whether if you are a makeup artist or you are just a person who likes makeup. When I first planned on using the Crayon Case products, I wasn't gonna give it a review. I was going to just use it in a video that I'm gonna be dropping sometime this month. I thought about it and I'm like, you know what? The Crayon Case deserves its own review. I need some water because the bitch is like thirsty. Oh wow. When you could drink some water and your lipstick not like, my lipstick is not on the top of my water bottle. Like, can we just talk about that? Girl, thank you guys so much for tuning into this video. Do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are interested in beginner makeup tutorials, if you're interested in product reviews, and so much more. Be sure to subscribe. Now I'm gonna give you guys the makeup details and I will catch you guys in my next video.